Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm going to take you through the first part of a three-part series where we're going to treat the upper, mid, and lower face. Today, let's go and watch the upper face. So the first thing we're going to do is treat the forehead with some dysport.
Okay.
And cleansing the area, and then I need to look at exactly what we're going to do. You mentioned that this brow sits a little bit lower. This is higher. Raise mm-hmm. your eyebrows. So obviously you have more movement on the right side. Mm-hmm. There's less movement over here. We're going to do less. Less here will help lift it. The other thing we're going to do, we're going to add some threads. We'll do three threads over here to build collagen and help provide lift over time. But also then we won't have to do any toxin lower. So raise up for me. The less we do here is going to be the better. So I'm going to start, stay up a little bit high. So you get a little tiny poke here. And it's a baby. It's a 31 gauge needle, real nice for this. So you'll feel a little bit. And this is going to kick in as soon as 24 hours, mm-hmm. which is nice. It's rather instant. It's as instant as it can get. The center we can treat, I'm going to tilt you my way, won't drop anything. It's very rare to get a medial drop, but as we move over, we have to be careful. We'll stay high. And even though that side moves, that's the side she likes better, the one that's higher. But we need to drop a little bit in here, or it will create a little bit of a spock, or it will look like it's exaggerated compared to this side. Now raise up here. Okay, so we won't drop any in here. We'll put the rest in the center. Now at the same time, I'm gonna grab a little bit more and let's do a brow lift. And we're gonna do a little more volume, a little more unit dosage on the lower brow. So we'll do a little more here. These are the downward fibers of the orbicularis oculi. They are pulling down, so when we treat them, it won't pull down. It will allow the static movement of the forehead that we didn't treat to pull up. So let's treat over here. We're going to do a little bit here. This is less of a dose because we have more inherent movement. Raise again. Raise your eyebrows. More inherent movement here. So that will help smooth that. Now I'll do a couple threads over here. So tilt this way. And it's nice because your arteries come out here above the pupil and a little medial. And this is a twist thread. We try and avoid all of the vessels we can see, but occlusion is not a risk with the threads. It is with fillers. So we keep a good level here and follow it through. And I like, this is a twist or a coil thread, and I like to do about three of these. So one above the other, and I see some vessels. What I'm doing is going below and circumnavigating the vessels I can see. Of course, you can't see them all the time. There is a little bit of a risk of a bruise, but it's not that common. And here we cleanse the area prior, and then we have three. Now you might leave them in, and some people believe that helps with hemostasis. Others believe if she were to move, it might create more bruising because it might then move the needle to where she is. So they removed, obviously no bleeding at all, so we were able to navigate tiger country there pretty well. Here I'm going to add some threads. Despite this being the brow that has the most movement, we still want collagen. We always want more collagen. And it will help smooth the area, make doing our Botox there much more easy. You can see the depth. You should always see the traversing path of the thread. That means you're at the right level. We cleanse before. Having it clean is key. These are coil threads, so there is a little more resistant to push on these twists. You know it's a twist because There's a large rubber stopper there, and that gives us a clue that it's a twist or a coil thread. And we'll do one more up here. Because there's more lines, it will help maintain the lift, but it will help smooth those lines because there's more movement. There's more movement where there's more lines. And then removing them, and I always like a little bit of pressure afterwards to prevent a bruise. So that's going to help build collagen up here and prevent the need for doing more neuromodulator above the brow that can lower it. So thanks for joining me today. We're going to do part two and the lower and mid face on the next video, so stay tuned for them. Add your comments below and join us on this channel, Facebook, and Instagram for further tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.